line action, and we're just about set to kick off. This coin toss presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Both teams have sent their special teams onto the field, and we're ready for the opening kickoff. He'll take it from the two. Makes it out to maybe the 19-yard line. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. He's out to the 30, and down he goes at the 34. They go with the option and pick up the first down.
Yeah, and that was a situation where the quarterback knew he could pick up the first down if he kept it himself. That's a good decision.
From their own 34-yard line, first down. He makes his way to about the 42.
Call it a gain of 8 yards. That makes it second and two.
Time right. Four down. Mike five. Green, number five.
Throws complete. He's got space to work. And he's taken down at around the 48-yard line.
Tight ends can really be a wild card in any offense. Sometimes the defense are a little bit confused on how to handle them.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 48. They're packed in tight on the line. He's at the 40. Tackle made at the 35-yard line.
That's a gain of 13 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
It's the tailback. Tackle right around the 22-yard line. What a run.
Here they give it to the tailback and a little misdirection play. And you can see the athleticism and the ability to make guys miss. Nice play.
From the 22-yard line, first down. Scrambling around. And they bring him down for a sack on the play.
Boy, this pass rush is sometimes scary. They're really getting after the quarterback now.
Defense looking for another sack here on this second and 13 situation. This is the eighth play of the drive. And he might want it all here, and does! And it's intercepted. And the quarterback just can't believe it. He really wishes he could have that one back.
Every quarterback has passes that he wishes he could have back. However, hey, a pick is a pick, and no one is going to care how bad he wants that one back.
From their own 20-yard line, it's first down. He's got an opening. Nice pitch and catch for the first down. That's a great tackle at the 47-yard line. Makes it out to about the 26.
Good solid running right there. Getting past the defensive lineman and into the secondary before he could be stopped.
Bring him down right around the 16-yard line.
Well, that's another first down, Brad. That's the fifth first down on this drive. You know, this offense isn't hitting a lot of big plays, but they're very, very consistent with their execution. It's putting a lot of pressure right now on this defense.
And he's tackled at the 15-yard line. Makes it to the five.
You talk about a masterpiece. This offense right now is working exactly the way they have planned all week long. You put in so much time as an offensive coordinator, as an offensive staff, on what you think might work. Put it out there and you wonder, how many adjustments are we going to have to make? Right now, this offense doesn't have to make any adjustments because their plan is working perfectly.
They bring him down in the backfield.
Things can get pretty fierce in this territory, but they look totally in control there.
And he converts the extra point. A nice 8-play, 81-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
And Brad, right now, the offensive line just winning the battle in the trenches, opening up some big running room.
So the score now, 7-0. Auburn to kick this one off. He'll return it from the three. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. The Tigers are right where they want to be early in this one, partner.
Well, this is what their coach talked about, getting off to a great start. The defense did their job, and it's nice to see the offense move the ball down the field and also get some points on the board.
I'm sure the quarterback would love to make amends for that last pick.
He can't dwell on the interception. There's still a whole lot of football to be played today.
He's got it with room to run. He's tackled at about the 33-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 33. The Tigers quarterback went down with that injury earlier. The bad news is it sounds like he's not going to be able to get back in this game. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it out, and it falls incomplete.
Number four was the intended receiver.
From their own 33-yard line, it's third down.
Mike five.
Yeah. Quick throw. He's taken down right around the 42-yard line.
I know the defense would have liked to have prevented such a big game, but the important thing is that they held and brought up fourth down.
He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. And we see this offense again after what you, Kirk, called a very physical touchdown drive.
Well, I say that, Brad, because the big hog mollies up front were able to create holes for the running game, and it helped them get the score. Let's see if they can do it again.
Brought down at the 21-yard line. Is up a score.
Kill.
Has some daylight. And they make the stop right around the 30. He tackles him for a loss. And that won't be enough for the first down.
Great job here by the defense in shutting down the run. That's a real boost for this team.
Oh, He's taken down at the 33-yard line.
Auburn's looking awfully impressive right now in defense, but we are in the first quarter.
Yeah, this is about as dominant a first quarter that we have seen in a long time. But let's see if they can continue to play this well throughout the rest of the ballgame.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. Straight up the middle, and he'll lose yardage. After one quarter of play, and we've got a low-scoring defensive battle on our hands. Auburn in front, 7-0. And we're back for more action here in quarter number two. Nice run up the middle. Third and 10 coming up. Ball on the 33-yard line. Here's the halfback on the screen. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield. That series left the offense scratching their heads a little. Makes it out to maybe the 40-yard line. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Auburn is up 7. And they'll get him in the backfield.
More plays like this, and the coaching staff is going to need to change up the blocking schemes. You can't allow the defense to play in your backfield.
Second and 13 coming up here. Ball on the 38-yard line. Throws, and that one's going to hit the ground incomplete. Under pressure. Catches it, and he's looking for more. He's brought down in the open field. Here's the throw, and I don't think he got anything on that. He's into the open field. Gains his way to the 26-yard line. Here's the give. He's pushed out of bounds at the 20. Makes it to the 11. Auburn up 7 points. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. For a loss. 10th play of the drive. Out of bounds at the 7. This one should be makeable. Auburn can make this a two-possession game with this field goal. The kick is up, and it is good. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Well, it's always fun to be part of a defensive battle, and that's certainly what we have right now.
Yeah, give credit to both of these defenses. I mean, they're playing with a lot of energy, and I think they're doing a nice job up front at the line of scrimmage. And at this point, they're not giving either of these offenses a chance to make a play.
It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. Makes it to the 37.
You talk about a dual threat guy. This guy can hurt you in the air or on the ground.
First and 10. Ball on the 37.
Here we go. Green 19.
And down he goes. Right around the 38-yard line. That play was going nowhere.
Yeah, give a lot of credit to the defense here, recognizing pass and swarming to the receiver.
From their own 38-yard line, third down.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football and check it down or take off and run with it.
They'll bring him down at the 24. Just about ready to call the first play of this drive. They were able to pick up a field goal on their last possession. Throws to the back quickly, off his hands, incomplete.
Number 21 was the intended receiver on the play.
From their own 24-yard line, it's second down. Pulls it in, first down, and he's knocked out of bounds. From their own 40-yard line, it's second down. Feeds it to the back. Tackle after a decent run up the gut. There's a strike complete, and he's taken down at about the 45.
Not a real fancy play here, just a smartly run route, good protection, and a well-placed ball. Most times, you don't need much more than that.
He scrambled. Tackle made around the 42-yard line. Called his own number on that one.
I like the idea of trying to run here, but the defense really made him pay the price for trying to run.
From the 42-yard line, second down. Quick strike to the back, and he drops it. And this play is number 8 on the drive. Slings it. Tackle at the 32-yard line.
Check, check.
scrambling.
He's going to take off.
They'll bring him down right around the 18-yard line.
Quick throw. Big play, and it's first and goal. Fires quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab.
Number 18, the receiver.
And this is the 12th play of the drive.
Brings him second and goal.
Tackles him hard at the 4-yard line.
Kill, kill, kill!
That's a
three.
Check nine, check nine.
That makes his third and goal.
Nine, two, three, 15.
He's on a run, and he's going to be sacked.
The offensive line has to at least slow the guy down a little bit. He was in there in no time.
So with the half ending, they're just going to try to put 3 points up on the board. He gets it up, and they tack on 3 points. So at the end of the half, Auburn in front, 13-0.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. Both passing games have struggled in the first half, David, and a lot of times you think of defensive backs being finesse-type athletes. A lot of physicality shown in that first half.
No doubt about it. And defensive backs, the ones that we like the best, are the ones that can play on an island and play extremely physical, because most offenses are predicated around timing and rhythm, and you see quarterbacks all the time in 7-on-7s and all summer getting with their wide receivers to try to get that perfect timing. And if you can jam them up at the line of scrimmage, you can mess up that timing. And doing a good job of that, playing close to the line of scrimmage, you know, not letting those receivers get too much wide open spaces and not giving away those easy completions. It's been a clinic so far the first half.
Just about time to start the second half. What do you think Herb Street's first point of analysis will be?
I don't know, something to do with quarterback play, I'm sure. I mean, we've got to hear that stuff all the time. It's all about the quarterbacks.
Brad and Kirk ready for the second half.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again. Here's the halfback. Taken down as he works the left for a nice gain.
Hey, kill, kill, kill! Back five, back five, back five.
Throws it in a hurry. And he's tackled around the 45-yard line. Immediately tackled.
Hey, kill, kill, kill. Four.
He has some room. He's at the 20 to the 10. Spectacular play, and now it's first and goal. Field for a loss. Might have been some early movement up front.
False start. Offense.
Just a middle lapse, but it's going to cost him 5 yards.
Still second down.
From the 7-yard line. Second down. tackled right around the 2-yard line. How about that play?
That's a good pickup there. He just dropped back and delivered a nice throw.
Converts the extra point. A 7-play, 80-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
So our score, 20-0. Fielded at the 4. Brought down at the 25-yard line. The Tigers continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Fires it out. He's hit and taken down. From their own 35-yard line. First down. He's taken down at the 35.
No gain. That makes it second and 10.
Down at the 43-yard line.
Third down.
They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. He's at the 40. And they make the stop at the 30-yard line. And he breaks one on third down.
Good call. Great execution. And again, we've seen this before, and the result is a big third down run.
Gets to about the 27-yard line. Second down and 7. Ball on the 27-yard line. They come out in a goal line set.
Here we go.
He gets out to about the 11-yard line. Tries to buy some time. Very good tackle in space.
Gain of 3 yards. That'll make it second and 7.
Here's the 8th play of the series.
Tight end right. Four down, four down. Mike five.
Let's go.
Run.
They give to the tailback. Knocked out of bounds at the 5-yard line. So it's third down now, and they're going to need about 4. Another pitch. They're not done yet. He makes the PAT. A nice 9-play, 74-yard drive. And they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
Well, the blocking up front was just amazing. I think that's what led them to those big runs.
And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
It's early in this game, so the defense can still have an opportunity to make some adjustments. But if things don't turn around in a hurry, it's really going to start to affect the psyche of that defensive line.
Tackled for a loss. From their own 21-yard line. Second down. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. And down he goes, around the 30-yard line. Back to the tailback, but he can't bring it in.
This wide receiver is very frustrated. You can tell by his body language. He did everything he needed to do to get open to be able to make a big play. The quarterback just didn't put the ball in the money.
It looks like they're going to go after this punt. He's tackled at the 40. So he managed to get a few yards on the run back.
Yeah, but I'll tell you, Brad, with so much traffic in the middle there, it really makes it tough to break free.
So their last drive resulted in 6 points. Do you think we'll see the same result on this one?
They ran the ball extremely well on their last drive. And until this defense figures out how to stop it, I think they'll have no problem moving the ball down the field.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Again, he'll get the call. Nice run to the outside. We played three, and this is not what the experts predicted. The Tigers with a 13-point lead. All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. Play and he'll lose yards. From the 50, it's second down. He's scrambling. And he's taken down around the 40-yard line. Hit out of bounds at the 23. First and 10. Ball on the 23-yard line. Throws incomplete, intended for his wideouts.
This just shows you that you don't need to be sacking the quarterback to disrupt the passing game.
Taken down in the backfield. And here's another third down. Got him. They tried to throw for it, but ended up getting sacked. And they're going to have to give the ball back after going
you can do there. You got to go for it and give yourselves a chance.
Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Nice run up the middle. Strike to his receiver, no good. They're about 4 yards away here on third down. Caught and big hit there to stop it. Less than 3 minutes in the game. And this one is a beauty. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. Fires across the middle. Tackle made around the 33-yard line. At the 41. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks.
That makes it second and two.
Can't get away from the pressure. Looks like someone got a head start on the line.
Once you're set, you've got to stay that way. The slightest flinch is going to be enough to draw the flag.
Second down and a ways to go because of the penalty. Throws, and that one's going to hit the ground incomplete. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. And they get the sack.
It's a big-time effort sack by the defensive end. I want to also give some credit to the coverage downfield. The end never gave up on the play, but because the quarterback didn't have anywhere to go with the football, it gave the defensive end enough time to eventually chase the quarterback down for that sack.
The sack makes this a fourth and very long. So a fourth down stop there late in the fourth quarter, and that should do it. Is looking to be a little bit more successful with this drive as they had to punt the ball away the last time they had it. Gives it to the back. Nice run to the left there. The Gators will use their first time out of the half. From the 21-yard line, it's second down.
Go, go, go.
They'll bring him down at about the 13.
Nothing tentative on that run at all. He looked very determined and got the first down.
And he's tackled after positive yardage. Florida will take their final timeout. After a decent run up the gut. Under a minute left. Huge touchdown on the ground, Herbie. That might do it. And he hits the PAT. A five-play, 24-yard drive, and they get it in for seven.
Boy, this offense right now is just being physical, really controlling the line of scrimmage, and it's opening up some nice big lanes for the running backs.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Auburn's just not going to let him come for air, I guess.
Well, this defense has just been stifling. They've shut down the running game. They've, for the most part, limited the big plays in the pass game. They've got a nice lead here in the fourth quarter.
I'm sure there are a lot of fans out there hoping for a miracle, but I seriously doubt we're going to see one today. Quick throw out to the receiver. Incomplete.
Well, he must have hurried there because his receiver was wide open. There was no need to rush that one at all.
So it's second and 10. Ball on their own 25. Pulls it in. First down, and he's knocked out of bounds. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. And he's tackled at the 46-yard line.
The defenders are really going to have to get their heads into this game. That was a big play, and on first down, no less.
And he throws it away. From the 46-yard line, second down. Left and tackled in a hurry. Picked up a yard of anything on that run. Throws quick to the receiver and it falls incomplete.
I mean, he has his wide receiver wide open. You spend all those hours during the week to be able to get prepped and ready to go. You got an open man like this, just step and deliver and make the throw.
So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. Last drive ended with as good a result as you can hope for, and I'm sure they'd like to replicate that here. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. Takes a knee. Going to do it for this one. Our final score, 27-7, Tiger. That brings this broadcast to a close. 3A Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.